Welcome back. I'm Alfred Lambert Weber, and it's a great privilege today to be with Magnus Olsson, who is the president of the World Coalition Against Covert Harassment, known as WorldCatch, who's coming today from Spain. Welcome, Magnus.
Thank you, Alfred. I'm happy to be on your show. On your interview.
Well, I understand that you're in Spain on a mission putting together the World Coalition Against Covert Harassment, going from country to country, putting together organizations that are part of this coalition. Could you just bring us up to date as to how many countries you've now visited and you've spoken to, and how many organizations are now coming together?
When I was in India for 1.5 months, just 3 weeks ago, we made a Indian cash with approximately 280 members. And in Spain, we are making, that's why I'm in Spain as well, to open up this Spain cash. And we already have that on the way moving, and they will have approximately 200 members. Then I have the Polish people. So we actually right now have I think it's 9 countries and about 5,600 members.
Yeah. How many countries with that? Because there's a bit of interference with the line. How many countries?
Approximately, we are about 9 right
nine.
Now.
Now, I understand also that you've started a USA catch in the United States. Is that correct?
Yes, that's correct. It's managed by Kate Ryan. She was the leader of the New England group, and she's very competent, and she's doing a great work. She is getting in hold of all of the whistleblowers. We have them on our team, like William Binney, Thomas Drake, Mr. Wibe, and so on.
These are very outstanding former National Security Agency, NSA, whistleblowers. Could you just tell us a bit about William Binney, for example, for those who are watching this video who may not be familiar with him?
Yes, of course. William Binney got the Adams Award. It was actually... that's comparable in the U.S. with the Nobel Peace Prize, because he woke up one morning and said, "What am I doing actually?" And he is the constructor of the Signet system that is working and listening and tapping and interfering through both telephone, mobile telephones, and also via television and all kind of electronics, actually. So we had the right guy there. He was actually, when he woke up that morning, and he went to New York Times and told the whole story about the surveillance that is carried out right now throughout the world. And he was arrested, I think it was 2 days after he went to the New York Times. There were 3 FBI men while he walked out the shower, pointing a gun at his head and took them with him. But they had to release him in 2 days. But other whistleblowers like Weib and Thomas Drake, they had the same experience, but they had to stay for a week actually in custody.
Right. Now, what are the goals, or what will each of these organizations that are part of the World Coalition Against Covert Harassment be doing in each of the countries?
We will have an agenda on our World Cash page, which will be up in about 2 weeks. We will try to support people with medical that is in bad medical situations, and we will also support them throughout our networking and putting pressure on the government and the so-called shadow government, the hidden area that don't even the politicians knows anything about. And so they work freely and they can do almost everything they do desire. Yes, that's about it. We are also putting together a war tribunal, which you will be yourself in, Alfred, and we will start our own counterintelligence agency throughout the world for the people, not against the people, as most of the intelligence today works.
Right. Now, these are for people that are targeted with what are called directed energy weapons, correct?
Yes, all types of different kind of energy weapons and the satellite system connected with the ground base, 5G systems that works with no limits of amount of transferring the intellectual property of everyone actually connected and hooked up on this system. And as this has been done for so long, from 1970, they started this up with implanting with the smart dust, the nano dust, whatever you call it, and they can nowadays hook up anyone they want, because they call this a legal warfare. You can just read the paper, Future of Strategical Warfare, written by NSA and NASA. So what I have in this document is astonishing things, because in another paper it's actually described how they put artificial memories into your system, and that actually changed your personality.
Right.
This is called messagens, nanocrystal nanobots.
Right. Now, you've actually been interviewed on this subject widely on international television. In fact, your interview on RT is one of the most widely viewed interviews in Spanish in RT history, correct?
Yes, that's correct. And We do have a version with English subtitling, so everybody could watch it. But and are about to produce a new type of getting out message. I'm gonna be interviewed tomorrow by a very, very famous ex-military, high military. Miller, English guy that has been working together with MI6 and so on, but he left this kind of crooky business, and he wants to help us. So, and he's a professional filmmaker. He has done commercials worldwide and so on. So he's very good, and we will produce this tomorrow, sir.
Now, this has been not without risks for you because on this past Saturday, Sunday morning, you ended up in the hospital being attended by 12 physicians and almost died. And could you tell us what happened there? And was this connected with your work establishing this new world coalition against covert harassment? Hello, Magnus?
First, of course, listen to this. I went into the hospital. Can you hear me? Can you
Yes,
hear me?
we can
Okay.
hear you.
Great, great. What was happening was when I woke up in the morning, I was shaking like a leaf, and my brain was cramping, and I've never, ever, during these 12 years of being targeted, experiencing something even close to this. And they did the same to the heart. And the doctors at this hospital was very, very professional, and they did all tests that is imaginable to carry out. They never found nothing was wrong with me. So they were afraid. They got scared because I fainted. I went unconscious, and it was a terrible thing. For 2 hours, they tried to save my life. Luckily, they succeeded. Now I'm back. I'm still very weak, but I'm getting it back slowly.
Right. So there's some force out there that the force that is actually deploying these directed energy weapons that is targeting you, so that you cannot go forward. But now they're all world-class whistleblowers, and more countries that are coming forward, including India, Spain, Sweden, Belgium, Poland, a total of nine,
UK,
the UK.
the UK cast will be a very big family of ours.
Yeah. Now, how can people get in touch with you to help support this effort and help bring people power to this so that these hidden war criminals who are targeting civilians, which is prohibited, this is genocide and crimes against humanity under the Geneva Conventions, under the Rome Treaty, under the International Criminal Court statute, under any international standard of international humanitarian law, of national laws, how can they get in touch with you to begin to support this effort so that
Yeah,
we can get
yeah.
laws started to stop this, and we can get a tribunal established to prosecute these people, to go. Apparently, some of the proof is that the Masons and the Free Mason organizations and the secret societies are the ones that are behind this, and they're protected. So how can people get in contact with you and the World Catch?
They have to go on because one of our the biggest sites actually the EU European Coalition Against Covert Harassment, the EU cache page was hacked down. So it has been down for quite a while, but we will put it up in a couple of days again, and then they could easily become members and support us. Otherwise, also with some donations. The donation button is on the page.
That's at ucach.org, ucach.org. Is that correct?
Yes, that's correct. But right now it's hacked down, and they did it so professional this time, so we have to recover it from WordPress, and this is not normal in any manner.
Also, there's a UCACH page, E-U-C-A-C-H, on Facebook, a group that people can join there and begin to get connected, et cetera, as you begin to put together this coalition. What will be the new website of the World Coalition Against Covert Harassment?
That's why we are making a movie, a pretty short one of 10 minutes that will be on the World Cache page. The World Cache page will be opened up in approximately 3 weeks from now, and it is astonishing. It's a very, very good page, and membership applications will be able to there as well.
Yeah. Do you have the URL, the link for it now that we can give out?
No. It should be wrong for me to do it.
Yeah. Okay.
At stage. Because they have been trying to interfere a lot with a person that's called Gary Owens.
I see.
That is actually a professional at website. He made the website for Coca-Cola and the biggest banks in the world and so on.
Yeah.
So we will have a page that is in that's why I'm producing the movie, the introduction, tomorrow with this professional old military man that lives close by here in Spain, and he has been experiencing some targeting himself, he told me. So this is on a broader scale that we ever could imagine.
Yeah. Now, as I understand it, Mr. Gary Owens, a very distinguished gentleman, will be joining the World Coalition Against Covert Harassment as its vice president.
Yes, that's correct.
Very good. Congratulations on that.
Thank you. And we will have some technical expertise groups. We have one in India. We have one in Europe, and so on. Actually, to even be able to track where the signals are coming from. and so on. I can't tell you right too much right now because it will be on slide while it's up.
Very good. Very good. Well, we've come to the end of this segment now, but is there anything that you had wanted to say now that you haven't had the opportunity to bring up yet?
Yes, and that's that the citizens of the world have to wake up because the plans of a futuristic warfare that is put together by the NSA, and NASA and CIA is astonishing. Reading. I got all the documents that are classified, and how the smart dust is distributed and so on, and the messages that is actually crystal nano particles that you just need to inhale that could actually attaches itself when it's out because it passes the blood barrier very fast, and then when it's out in the blood, it attaches itself to the right frequencies in your brain.
So this is really part of the transhumanist agenda to robotize humans. Is that correct?
Yes, that's what it's all about. And they have came very far with this. And we estimate that there is about 6 million people connected in just Europe. And but only a couple, like 100,000 or 200,000 do know that they are hooked on an online with on these kind of systems. They clone your brain to a super quantum computer that the whistleblower called Dr. Robert Duncan from the CIA told me all about. Because you can just imagine by the name, the Bodo Doll project. I mean, they clone your brain into their super quantum systems, and whatever they do there affects you in real time, directly, instantly. And there is just a fifth to 50 second operation, and the lowest you can get to that could be measured up is by atomic power devices. It's about the attoseconds. They are very close to real time, but this is working by 50 seconds. And that's important for people to know. And they are trying to take over well, I'm sorry. It's actually about the morphological side. The morphological system in your brain is what makes everyone on Earth different. So what they are trying to do here, are trying to achieve, is to be able to control the morphological system as well.
Right. Does artificial intelligence figure into this system as well?
The artificial intelligence, the AI systems, the strong artificial intelligence, deep mind artificial intelligence, And also the light, so to speak, they call it the light versions of this as well. But when you have the deep mind connection, the artificial intelligence will actually take over your life. And if they could manage, they haven't, and I hope they could now, but to take over the morphological system that makes us as who we are and so on. And then we have another part that is very important, and that's the real time, so to speak. I mean, when the morphological system produces a idea that is personal, they are able to read it and catch up with it, and they are storing all of this information from the 6 million people just in Europe that is up online. They are constructing the system, and their goal is to be able to rule over the morphological system as well.
Right. So your the goals of the WorldCatch really are to deconstruct the transhumanist agenda. That's your goals.
Yes, and I will say something that's pretty astonishing now, because we are going to be licensed as an intelligence ourselves, but we are for the people, not against the people, and that's a huge difference. And we will be able to provide with legal support, medical support, and so on. This is really serious. I've been working on this project for half a year, and
For example, could you get a court order for them to give you the names of the 6 million persons that they have online so you can inform those 6 million persons so the 6 million persons could bring lawsuits against them officially?
What we are able to do right now is to we are close to be able to find and record what is going on, but it will take a couple of months for us to get the device together, because right now we have seven, or I think it's eight even, different kind of machinery that is tracking and trying to block the system. But as we all know, the scalar waves that they use, both the magnetical ones and the electrical ones, is hooked up on the inner sphere of the Earth. There is seven very big and strong electromagnetic systems that's called the scalar mainframe system, that is hooked up on the 5G system that is coming out and from a Swedish company called Ericsson. And the Ericsson is delivering the vibe. They are the best. They were the one who constructed the 4G, the 3G first, then the 4G, and now the 5G. That is just amazing.
Right. Well, we look forward to your future reports, and we would encourage you to come back. We certainly want to thank you for taking your time out today, and we invite you to come back as often as you wish with updates on the progress of the WorldCatch, and also to begin to educate our viewers more on the progress that is being made in exposing all of these details of how the NSA, the CIA, and other organizations are trying to impose the transhumanist agenda, and how your our mutual organization, the World Coalition Against Covert Harassment, and other organizations are beginning to deconstruct and really stop this effort. Are there other topics that you'd like to talk about now that you haven't had an opportunity to talk about?
Oh yes. You know that the human resonance is a natural resonance wave, standing wave, that is supporting our brains. That one is being reproduced artificial just above the normal human resonance, and there's also one below. So they are actually trying to even control that part. And the human resonance, the natural human resonance, is raising each year, and that makes us more clever. And but they have now, through the HARP systems, actually created their own human resonance standing waves, and that's a big importance for us to enlighten and to be able to deconstruct, because they're using it at this moment just for, actually, as they did to me, for 2 hours in the hospital. I was there for very, very long, for 8 hours. But in 2 hours, the whole medical team of 12 doctors, and they couldn't explain it, because they took all the tests on me and everything showed out to be perfectly. And then a very good and close friend to me told them that what I'm working with and about, and they were actually looking up the web pages, mind control, Stasi. They were looking at the mind dash computer brainimplant.com page. So and they were pretty amazed about it, but they got a bit afraid during these 2 hours. All these doctors thought I was transferred to actually the department of the hospital when people are about to die.
Right. Well, this is very close to the first anniversary of the death of one of the founders of UCATCH, and now of the WorldCATCH, Dr. Rauni Kilda. And I wonder if you have any observations on her death, because she was assassinated in the same way that there were attempted to assassinate you on Saturday and on Sunday. What do you think she would have said now that we're moving out into the World Coalition Against Covert Harassment?
She almost always, I'm sorry, I'm getting a bit sensitive about it, because I love this woman by heart. And she always told us, the whole group, that we are on the winning team. We will eventually take over this. And now we have soon an upper own intelligence that will provide help to all the TIs and all the people that believe that their thoughts and the intellectual property are stolen.
Right. Exactly. Exactly. So, what do you think is the single thing that our viewers watching your statements and watching our interview, what is the single thing that they can walk away from this interview with that they can do to further stopping this transhumanist agenda, which has a very hostile intent toward humanity? They want to terminate free will and soul-based humanity and, terminate the human race as we know it.
Yes, that's a fact. What I would like to say is that we have to counteract survival, then we do have to get the HARP systems illegal and put down, because they are the support just to the 5G system that is already brought up onto the military years ago. That will be published and reachable for the human common citizens sooner or later. But these systems are working together with the satellites and the ground-based inner electromagnetical scalar fields. So I made a visit to Montauk. I walked it all around, and I made a few reports from there. You can have a watch at them. That's where MKUltra started up, and so on. But very close, just 10 minutes by car, is the biggest Tesla tower, and it's still standing there. And the point with the Tesla tower was that it's very high, it's extremely high, and he could send electricity to catch up with the inner streams, the seven inner streams inside of the Earth. This tower, and this was possible to walk down and see. It's 3 times deeper than the height of the Tesla tower. So this is actually working with the electromagnetic scalar waves and magnetic scalar waves, and they are working together. Together openly, we have been able to read this. We have been able to, in Faraday cages, the scalar waves are just going through like nothing. It's very hard to stop them. The only way is to actually contrasend scalar waves to stop the other scalar waves. So and we have a technical team in the US and in the world class. We have a couple as well. So we're about to try to put the whole system down. And Russia is actually, when they made the interview with me for half an hour, that was sent in front of 45 million people. You can just have a look at it. It's all over the place. But on YouTube, you can just write in Magnus Olson RT, and then it comes up, and it's I mean, as RT has become the biggest news network in the world, they are not inflected or any in any kind. There's no way to stop them, so to speak, compared with other news networks that is usually owned by the Rothschild family. which is a part of this and is actually on top of the Bilderberg group. And so is some the owners of Ericsson is also in the Bilderberg group. And Ericsson is their biggest part of delivering technology today is to the military, and you can just imagine why.
Right. Now, I know that amongst the legislation that the World Coalition Against Covert Harassment, WorldCash, is looking at is a world model statute that can be adopted by world organizations at the world level, regional organizations like the European Union, individual nations. From Russia, like Russia, other nations that wish to, but that would ban HAARP, would ban all of these directed energy weapon systems that are necessary to implement the, yeah.
NASA, not NSA, NASA is writing in their warfare, strategical warfare agenda. You can read all about it, but it's actually official because they are forced upon publishing it. Because if they do not do that, they are working illegally. Because they are calling this a warfare that is legal, but that's just their points of views. That's wrong, and that's very, very, very wrong, I would say. And war troops were world. Tribunal against this kind of crimes will be effect sooner or later, and also the World Intelligence Service that will contract infiltrate. We already have a lot of whistleblowers with us. But there is also some guys inside of the MI6 and the MI5 that is supporting us. The most of these people that are working with this is actually against it, but it's their work because I mean to go on to a person's brain, the personality is broken down. You're not able to achieve anything. You can have goals, you can have your hopes and so on, but they could even bring down that so you don't even have any dreams or possible actual free the free this decision the freedom of decisions is being taken away from us as personalities. And the 2045 project with Theodore Berger that already invented the memory extensorship. I mean, you could switch it off and on, but when you have it on, you become another personality, and you are fed with information throughout the super quantum systems that is up and running already. please go on, Arthur.
Yeah, no, I was just looking at that. Now, some of the findings, for example, we had a panel yesterday, and some of the information that came out in the panel yesterday, by a gentleman who did his dissertation, his doctor's PhD dissertation on this, was that the human cell level, both in the brain and then in other parts of the body, has what's called the endocannabinoid system, and there are CB1 receptors in the brain and CB2 receptors throughout the body. And what they found is that cannabinoids, which are based on the plant cannabis, actually have the function of neutralizing some of the technologies of the that the transhumanist agenda is attempting to use. And so I would hope that the World Coalition Against Covert Harassment, we can make the introductions to these individuals that are working on these sciences at the PhD level. We can make the introduction so that you can also incorporate that research into the very valuable defenses that can be used by the individuals against these technologies.
What I need to tell you a bit about why this is going on around the whole globe is because of the artificial intelligence has to know about every culture, every type of different country agendas and so on. So the artificial intelligence is learning each day, and it's called pipes, what it's fed with. And one of the pipes is your brain. And when they have so many million already in Europe, feeding pipes do not just have to be brains. It can also be supercomputers that are actually stripped of their ability to both work and all of the information can easily be stolen by these people, just as they steal our intellectual property without even making a noise out or from their own. So the person that is hooked up do not know anything about this kind of technologies, but what these groups are doing around the world is that they are stealing international, they know the intellectual part of our thinking.
Right. So this is like a wholesale takeover and theft of the human culture and the human race as a resource.
Yes, and the linguistics, and that means for people who don't understand. And that's our way of speaking, talking, and thinking together. And they are mapping this around the world now, and everything is fed by these pipes to what they call the mainframe, Mr. Computer. And that's an artificial intelligence straight through, and the artificial intelligence is learning and picking up so fast, so it can actually take over the control of personality pretty easy right now.
Right. So So this is very, very dire. So what do you see? Are you optimistic about the future of the human race? Do you think that we can defeat and stop this?
Alfred, that question it's a very good question, and I will answer it like this. We must be, we could call it soldiers for humanity, and that's the average citizen that has to reckon what is actually happening around the world at this point. And the takeover is being done bit by bit. And the figure, the estimation of 6 million was made 2 years ago. So just imagine how many people are hooked up online right now in Europe. And in the US, it's even worse. It's terrible.
Right,
And
right.
also Canada, Dr. Cameron, one of the biggest leaders of the MK Ultra, he worked from based upon Canadian ground. And what his aim was just he worked together with the Sociedad Delgado and Dr. Jacobson, I believe that was both. Delgado was from Spain, but he was recruited by the CIA, and so was this Dr. Jacobson from Norway. And now I'm talking about the 60s. So you can just imagine how fast, how under how long time they have been developing this. And right now it's the nano, and the nano part was brought up and started up. They started up to using it already in the 80s, when nobody knew anything about this kind of technology.
Right. Well, what I'm thinking is that we're already approaching almost 1 hour, and what I would like to do is that to suggest that we would like to invite you back for an interview in 3 weeks or so, once the website of the World Catch is up, the World Coalition Against Covert Harassment is up, so that once your website is up, we would like to invite you back for an interview, so we can begin to go through the website and begin to explain to the world and to our viewers exactly what the rollout in the various countries is and how people can become involved. Does that seem like a good approach to you?
A very good one, actually, Alfred. I appreciate it because, and I would like to do some personal interviews on artificial intelligence, how it's actually working through the quantum systems today, that is already up and running. And this is the biggest threat, actually, to the humankind, because when you have the hive mind, which will be the result, but the hive mind in for the right people is what I believe that these people are working towards. So this will not be able to get for the normal citizen.
Right.
I can just tell you a few things what Robert Duncan and I were speaking on. His name is Dr. Robert Duncan, and he's a whistleblower from the CIA. And when he worked on his project, it was called the Vodou Doll Project, and that says it all. But he told me that they were working on the mind melt, the function, the swarming theory, and so on. The swarming theory is artificial intelligence-based system that's mainly produced to be used on the battlefield. It means that 50 soldiers that are hooked up with each other, if somebody sees a threat, everybody else know it by an atto second. That means almost in real time. So this will also be used among people sooner or later. When you're entering different areas, there will be signs that right now you can operate on our level and get all the updates, all everything you need to know about the area you are supposed to enter.
Right.
So what I know about the artificial intelligence is pretty amazing because I was studying with some people that is developing this kind of strong artificial intelligence, as they call it, when it's about the deep mind, or AI.
Right, exactly. Good. So tell me, do you want then to leave this? Would you like to leave our viewers with some final thoughts now?
Yes. I would love to see that people are getting aware. They are up next, so to speak. So nobody will be able to flee or get away from this kind of system. They are worldwide, and I am sure that we will reach a ban on everything. We have good connection in the United Nations, for example, that have already ruled out some cases, and we will work with them on a certain level as well. I would also tell people that do not think that this kind of technologies will be able to take over humanity. We will fight back, and what you can do best is to be informed, to read for example, my web pages, the nanobrain.com, and the mindcomputer.com, or the mindcontrol.se page, as they are up and running again because they hacked them down. Mind control was hacked down around 57 times, I think we're up to now. And we have had over 500,000 visitors over the last year. And though we have been so much hacked down, and so for the people in general, they should be aware. Get the information. There is several other web pages than mine, but you need to take this seriously because if you do not see if you do not act upon these warning signals, you're up next. I'm sorry to tell people like that, but So we will encounter, we will stop this, and we will free people, but we need to do it together. That's why I'm opening up the caches around the whole world, and the World Cache will be the head organization over all of this kind of organization. As we have so many members already, you can just imagine when we get around 10, 15 million. And that's what we are trying to do with the World Cache page.
Right. Good. Well, thank you very much, and thank you for taking out your time. We're all very happy that you're alive and well after this attack, that you were surrounded by 12 physicians, and it was amazing because the doctors were took all these tests. They watched what was happening to you. They knew by normal medical protocols that they couldn't figure out was what was happening, and yet knew that you were at death's doorway. They went to the internet. They discovered all of the science behind these directed energy weapons, and now they had a whole paradigm shift. So you have to give it credit to the physicians of Spain that are open-minded and that are certainly more open-minded than I've come across, the physicians of the United States and the physicians of Belgium that I have seen, and the physicians of the United Kingdom generally than I have seen for physicians in who were involved in urgent care around you to have done a paradigm flip and to say, "Oh my God, we have never seen this." And then to really understand is quite amazing. So we're really grateful for this kind of miracle, medical miracle, which occurred.
Yes, thank you a lot, Alfred. And I had the same point of view. They were very, very professional. Actually, Shane has become number three on the list of best doctor teams in the world. So
Okay.
it was very good professionals that saved my life,
Yeah.
but they had never seen something even close to this.
Yeah.
This was complete. And I will tell you that I got some very heavy medications. I got the strongest antibiotics and some other kind of medicines. That's why I'm a little bit slow. I'm a little bit tired because this happened just 2 days ago. So, but I will be up and running, and we will win. We are on the winning team, and
Right.
that was the message from Ronnie all the time to
Yeah.
me. So now I'm saying it to the world: we are on the winning team. That's
Right.
it.
Right.
Yeah.
Amen. On that note, forward, and we look forward to our next interview in a short while, as soon as the World Catch page is up. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Alfred.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.